Wyldside Radio Show. The wildest radio show on the planet.
Cory here on the Wyldside Radio Show, broadcasting from Rocklahoma. That's right. I got the band. This is the band that I came to see. One of my favorite bands. That, you know what? I've been jonesing for a long time, but these guys never get out of Canada. I got the band Helix. I got, yes, the vocalist, Brian. And, of course,
great to be here.
Brent and Sean. Sean's kind of an old school friend of mine, too, from the band Crash Kelly.
That's right.
So it's kind of nice to have you guys here. What do you think about Rocklahoma? Obviously, you're sweating.
Love it. Love it too. We need to get a slot on the night, so it's a little cooler.
We're kind of capitalizing on it, calling it the swamp ass capital of the world, with the humidity and the heat. So it's getting a little brutal. Brian, one thing I wanted to talk to you about. This is, you know, last year you guys actually did a CD. What was it called? It was called the Heavy Metal Christmas.
Heavy Mental Christmas.
Mental Christmas. The thing I liked about it so much about was in fact that you guys donated proceeds to a church, correct?
Oh, no, not that one. You're talking about another album. I actually did two. I did a Christmas album for my church, and we raised $10,000 in like...
Oh, that's killer.
3 weeks. It was for the building fund to expand the church, right? My wife stood outside and helped us sell CDs, and it was funny because we were Catholic, so we were standing outside after the first mass, and we moved like about $2,000 worth of CDs after the first three masses, and we moved like $2,000 after each mass.
I
went, oh my God, I wish Helix CDs sold this good.
I know. That's awesome.
But anyway, it's funny because I'm a classically trained singer, and actually Sean is a classically trained guitar player. And when I sing at church, I sing in a classical voice. I don't sing in a rock voice.
Right, well, you teach as well, too, right?
And I teach. I'm probably one of the foremost experts on bel canto in the world, which is the old Italian method of singing.
Right.
But when I sing at church, I get these little gray glints, you know, the bleach set. The old ladies, the blue hairs, right?
Yeah.
And they come from out of town to hear me sing, and they don't know I'm in Helix. They come to hear me sing classical music, which is pretty cool. So
is that right?
I got all these 70-year-old groupies, which...
Now, Brian, this is your lovely wife over here, correct?
No. This is a good friend of mine.
Good friend.
We've known each other for many, many years. Mm-hmm. Actually met back in Colorado Springs in 1983. We've been friends ever since.
Nice long haul.
My wife is actually at home, and believe it or not, she decided not to come. She comes out to a lot of gigs with me, and she helps me run the band. And just before we're about to leave, she got a really bad case of pneumonia.
Ooh.
And so it was a good thing she didn't die of flight, because there was no way she was going to be traveling.
Absolutely.
So, but she's getting better. A lot of people know my wife through emailing me and from coming to visit us at Planet Helix. My house is actually built from architectural antiques that I've salvaged from the London, Ontario region.
I've seen this on MTV Cribs.
And if you watch that show, you can see my wife, Linda, and me on the show. And her big thing is the fridge.
The fridge. Why is it with women with the fridge? You know?
Funny thing is, right? She got this, she wanted a fridge that had, you know, we could get water and ice cubes and shit out of the fridge, right? So, I said, okay, we'll go get one. So she went to like Sears Outlet, you know, you get a little dip in the thing and you get half off the fridge. So I'm working on the backyard. She said, okay, I bought a fridge. So I look out in the truck and there's this monstrous fridge. It's like huge, right? And I said, how the hell are you going to get that in the house? And here's my wife's logic. How does everybody else do it?
I don't know.
Well, they can do it. We should be able to do it. So we ended up taking the friggin' door off and the hinges and the trim on the door. But now we have a fridge that opens up. But you see in that show.
I did. It was good. So tell me, Brian, what's it like traveling with these guys? I mean, how do you guys get along? And, you know, who's the backbone behind it? Who's the jokester? Huh?
Oh, man. That's a loaded question.
I want to say, you know, as we're veterans, We've dealt with all the crap that there is out there. We've seen it, been there, done that. There's not really too many hassles anymore. When something screws up, we just expect that. We've seen it before. So we just deal with it and move forward. That's what.
So especially Brent and I, because Brent and I are like brothers. We spent, you know, a large part of our lives living together. And in the early days in band, the circuit up in Canada, we were together 7 days a week for months on end on touring. And, you know, we had funny things happen to us. The only near fight we got into, Brent threw his guitar up in a tree.
Oh, no.
Didn't break.
Didn't break. Did you get it back? Did you get it back?
Yeah, some guy gave it back to me. I never thought I'd ever see it again.
That's right. Okay, you guys done Rocklahoma. Obviously, you guys are going back home to Ontario again.
Did you say that?
It's been a long day.
It's Ontario.
Ontario. But you guys are going doing Rock Gone Wild coming up here in August 23rd.
Yeah,
right?
Baby. Oh, yeah.
Looking forward to that.
Yeah. And this is some good U.S. exposure for you guys, because you guys really haven't hit the States very much.
And that's outside of Des Moines, Iowa somewhere.
It's Algona.
Algona. That's right. I did read that.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I tried for years to get the band back in the United States, and like I said before, I think the fact that we lost some of the key members of the band, Paul was killed, as you know, and Brennan left the band, and Fritz said to move to Florida. I think that made promoters cautious of once again hiring the band. You know, the club dates we did get that I would go down and play, like, they were pretty hurting, like, no lights, bad PA, and guys couldn't buy to hire the band. And then finally got the gig last year where we really could showcase the band. And this year I've had several offers to play U.S. bars and I've turned them down, even though the money's good. I think a proper venue is a setting like this where there's a variety of bands on one bill, you know, nothing attracts a crowd like a crowd. And we're on with some of the greatest bands in the world. They've been around, and like you said, it's a good venue to see the band, and I think it's going to lead to getting us more U.S. dates in a concert situation.
Yeah, I hope to see you guys with some more U.S. dates, because, you know what, unfortunately, I didn't get to see you guys, but I have a friend that's got a little bit of video it's doing, so I'm going to go back and watch it. Since I was stuck here in the trailer, but I'm very excited to see you guys here. When you guys get back home, say hello to Daryl, Dwarf Money.
Can I get a copy of this video? Can I get a copy of this video?
Yes.
Great.
Absolutely. Say hello to him, slap him on the side of the head for me, and say, Cory said hello. He knows where I'm coming from. But, you know, like, again, I want to, you know what, thank you for being on the show, and I wish you guys nothing but the best of your future endeavors. Thank you. Get some more U.S. gigs, guys. It's going to be nice to see you down here again.
There you go,
my friends. Yes, the band Helix right here on the Wyldside Radio Show. We're still broadcasting from Rocklahoma. Stick around. I still got great interviews coming your way. And that's right, the best music you ever got your dirty little fingers on.
Wyldside Radio Show. The best 80s music.